All right. Insomnia TrueSilver Championship. I'm Noxious, and with me, Lothar. We're onwards to the final stages of the online qualifier, right? We're going to be casting the quarterfinal up next. We're going to have Leon versus Vanilla Warrior, I think. Vanilla Titan, right? That's the name.
Yeah, Vanilla Titan. And we've seen him in some tournaments in the past, but to be honest, I can't remember which ones, and I didn't have the time to actually check it up. But his name is ringing a bell. Maybe in the meantime, I will Google something when we'll be casting the games. But it's important to say that we have three matches left: one quarterfinal, one semifinal, and the grand final. And the finalist, the winner of the final will get the accommodation and the travel to Insomnia's
the live event.
The LAN event, but I would say it's a major event. It's $30,000 for the prize pool for the whole tournament. So that's a huge event, even bigger prize pool than the second DreamHack Bucharest, and that's saying something. So it's I would say that's a really pretty big prize to get for playing in an online qualifier.
Yeah, I mean, if you think about it, it's big enough to get the major title, right? So if you end up winning the entire thing, you have a major win under your belt, and that means you're in teams' spotlights, right? Like, as a result of that, every single team, they're still looking to, you know, recruit people, and you're always going to be considered talent. As soon as you make top eight, you know, people start paying attention to what you do, and then it's a matter of seeing your consistency, and then eventually entering a team becomes very realistic. So that's definitely a big deal for whoever ends up taking this. For the next match, we've got Leon versus Vanilla Titan. They're both playing the same lineup: Warrior, Paladin, and Druid.
And I know from where I know Vanilla Titan now, because he is a part of Esuba, the Czech esports team, and I assume that we were playing with them a lot during this Seed Story Cup first team tournament, because we played a lot against Suba as Planet Key Dynamics back then. So that was
yes,
fun.
Oh my god, that's right. Oh goodness, that goes way back.
Yeah, I was in team with Xixo back then.
Why is he not in G2?
Well, you know. Stuff happens.
Yeah, he's doing fine in Na'Vi, is all we're gonna say, right? Na'Vi is, you know, yeah, Na'Vi's a team that's doing just right now, so definitely they've all got a good spot. So Leon and Vanilla Titan, we haven't seen much of them. We saw Leon a bit earlier. We saw Vanilla Titan, I think, for a fraction of a second before the match ended. He came in like the second game. He was on his way to win already, but because they have a similar lineup, we can probably say that we expect. I want to say Control Warrior, mid-range Druid, and Secret Pally, just based on what we've seen today. But maybe I'm forgetting something and one of them is playing Control or mid-range.
Yeah. Well, everyone, actually, was the single Control deck that we have seen was the Warrior, like twice. Right? There was no Handlock. Every single Warlock is basically Zoo and mid-range Reno, and that's basically
right.
It.
Because yeah, we have two variants of Zoo too, right? There's like the Zoo that we saw Naiman play, which is kind of classic with Void Terrors. And then we have the other one, which is a Reliquary Seeker. We have like two variants of it. But yeah, it's pretty much Reno, Jackson, or Zoo. There's no Handlock.
Yep, that's true. And it's interesting because usually when we see the main events, the big tournaments, people are playing mostly Control decks, right? They usually have a aggro lineup, I mean some aggro decks in their lineup, but usually players feel that they are the best with control decks, with decks that are like dependent on the decision the most. And that was the case, example with a Patron Warrior. The strongest players were feeling like this is the deck for them because it requires the most thought, the most decision making, but at the same time, of course, it's kind of too powerful, so no wonder it got hit by the nerf hammer.
It's kind of interesting that you bring it that way, because you know, it's a game where sometimes you can let the cards play themselves, but some people prefer having a lot of control over what happens, whether it's a bad play or a good play, right? All they want is to make sure that they have as much control over what happens, over the outcome, and that really distinguishes many players. And one of the things to keep in mind, and that I loved, that I noticed when I went to Seed Story Cup, was there was this player named Elky, which is now in Liquid. A lot of you probably know the name if you've been around esports. Elky's a pretty big big guy, you know, name-wise, and he basically stated that he felt more comfortable playing with Secret Pally and, you know, Tempo Mage with Spell Slingers and Unstable Portals against somebody, say, like Tice or, you know, RDU, like the top players, because a lot of the outcomes weren't really decided on his own terms. So that gives him an edge because the opponents can't play around every single thing. He feels like their decision making would be better. And so using those easier to play decks with variants would give him a bigger edge against those guys. And it is true. It is absolutely true. So it's really just a matter of understanding your own positioning, you know, regarding other people. And that's why a lot of people who think they're the top want to play decks that take a lot of decision making, because they think their decision making is better than everyone else's.
Yeah, that's a good analysis, and I have nothing to add here. I mean, it's clear as sun that if you're not as well prepared as other players, the players that are playing the game for a really long time and they spend a lot of time preparing for every single tournament, even though some of them they were practically exhausted for playing BlizzCon and preparing for a different type of Hearthstone event because they were preparing for Conquest, you're still in a worse spot than them. So most likely you would like to be the aggressive player, the beatdown player that dictates the pace of the game.
Yeah, definitely. So it just kind of makes sense. You know, there was a time where Tempo Mage, Hunter, Druid was kind of the go-to lineup, and now you see a lot of these people playing Secret Paladin as the go-to aggressive deck. I feel like Control Warrior is being picked up by a lot more people, though. You know, where Control Warrior used to be the deck that very few specialists played, now it seems like everybody's kind of adding it to their roster. I think maybe the margin of error when you're playing Double Brawl is a bit smaller. It's one of those things where if you play Double Brawl, if you play Justicar True Heart, the margin of error is diminished a lot. You can't make as many mistakes by playing cards like these, especially the Double Brawl, because it gives you an extra safeguard. You know, you don't have to play Unstable Ghoul shenanigans and try to time it flawlessly. You have a Brawl, it's kind of a just go all in and clean the board.
Yep, that's true. And also, another factor maybe you missed that. I think the Control Warrior was not as popular some time ago because people didn't have the cards.
That's right. Yeah, legendaries. Turns out they're pretty expensive.
Yeah. I mean, that's a legit concern because, you know, people were just grinding out cards in the meantime. Not every single player is just dishing out cash for the cards.
So, yeah. That's correct. So, Vanilla Titan playing Secret Paladin, I think, against Patron. We saw this matchup earlier. We mentioned that technically Leon should be favored in that he's playing the, you know, Whirlwinds, that he needs to clean up all the 1-1s. But at the same time, Secret Paladin is able to take games against every single deck. That's one of the things it does best, and that's why it's so scary to play against.
Yeah, that's true. And I mean, the thing that Vanilla Titan has to just make here is just stay on curve, apply pressure, and be sure not to die to weapons so your opponent can't really get them in the head. Because that's the only thing you can play.
Yeah, like pray to the gods. That's pretty much all you can do. Now, Vanilla Titan here opting for the Haunted Keeper is a very good play because it guarantees that he's able to get himself a target for Blessing of Kings later down the line. And he's also able to do a cool, you know, he's got a lot of coin plays. He can go for Kings, he can go for Consec, he can go for True Silver. Obviously, the best one here is obviously True Silver Champion because you can deal with this Frothing Berserker without being too worried. And you can follow it up with even more aggression. I like that a lot.
Yeah, me too. I mean, Frothing Berserker is that type of minion that you have to deal almost immediately, especially when you play a deck like Paladin who has the access to Master for Battle, which spawns the board, right? So, makes sense.
Yeah. Leon is getting the dream if he wants to pick it up. Deathbite, and then you follow it up with a turn 5 Patron Inner Rage, trigger the AoE, maybe even get yourself a crazy Battle Rage as a follow-up. I feel like right now Leon's looking pretty good if he wants to be. It just depends how Vanilla Titan approaches this turn.
Yep, and this is as you said, this is the dream setup. This is something that will be, I think, just an autopilot from Mal point, right? Because you have to spawn the board as soon as possible.
Yeah, and Vanilla Titan doesn't want to play Kings. Doesn't want to play Muster. Doesn't want to play anything, because he knows that whatever he plays dies.
Mm-hmm.
So do you go for kings to push more damage?
I think you should go for the kings.
There's really little else, right? Because on 5, you can still play Knife Juggler with Muster, assuming there's no patron. And if there is a patron, then... Well, may God be merciful. I have no follow-up for this. This is really devastating.
Well, you can always play... No, we can't. I mean,
Avenge Muster, I guess. You could play Avenge Muster, and you attack the 1-3 with your weapon. Well, you attack first, obviously. And then when the AoE goes off...
Not sure if that's the correct play. Double Knife Juggler is very risky. Because if there will be... Actually, it's not that risky.
This is the closest thing to an anti-patron play as you're going to get, right?
Yes, because you can clear one of the patrons.
I kind
of
like it.
But I'm not sure if there's a way you can clear patrons anyway.
Well, with the True Server Champion and the Double Juggler, I think Vanilla Titan took the line of play that was the single best against that exact outcome, because he's keeping himself a weapon that can kill a 3-3. He has Consecration to kill the 2-health ones, and now it's just a matter of getting rid of the 3-health ones. And he's going to be able to do that quite easily, right? With the weapon.
Yep.
And the Juggler, so he's good. He's got the board clear, and you can even set up an Avenge on the back of it if he wants. Very well played by Vanilla Titan here, defusing the craziest play from Patron.
So let's see. He'll clear that, he'll clear that. He will stay off cure, but he will set up the Avenge for next turn. And Avenge next turn means if he will not pick up a Mysterious Challenger.
You can play everything, right? Not your kings, but you can play the other two minions that you have, and they're very solid.
You probably don't want to play Blessing of Kings if you can't attack with the minion first. So,
right.
But at the same time, you're aware that your opponent is playing a deck that has plenty of AoEs, and this might pose a problem. Might intimidate Vanilla to spam the board. But I think he has, unless he drops something really, really heavy. Okay, never mind. Double Master Battle. Man. Now yeah, he has to play one. There's no choice at all. You have to do it.
And he's curving too, right? With the second one. If the first one doesn't stick because AoE hits, then you've got a second one with a +4/+4 on one of your minions. Leon, however, used Battle Rage last turn to cycle one card, got himself a Shredder, really helping out. And he can also play the Belcher that he just picked up. This is looking very good for the Patron player. Things are going to have to go super wrong for Vanilla Titan to have a really great chance going forward. Everything is gone. I mean, Fiery War Axe, play the Belcher.
Yep.
And Leon's looking good.
Basically, the Belcher might be... Well, it wouldn't be that Blessing of Kings, the Belcher might have been sealing the game right now. But there is the Blessing of Kings to turn the game around. Again.
So do you buff your... Like, do you buff your Spider? Because the advantage of doing that is that if Execute hits, at least you have a backup plan. The one ones are kind of your backup plan, if that's even something to consider. Oh, by the way, Lothar, Vanilla Titan is no longer an Isuba.
No, he isn't. Then they should change the info on Liquipedia.
Aha! Gotcha, Liquipedia. Usually they always have everything up to date. I like how they have the tournament scores up before the tournament's over. Like, it's always pretty crazy how fast they update their stuff. Alright, so he's gonna bank on the fact that there will be no execute. Or at least he's gonna hope that that's not the case. He's at least able to clear up the board quite nicely. I mean, even with this, if execute is used here, it means it's not gonna be used on bigger things, but... Oh my god. Unstable Ghoul.
Unstable Ghoul, but it has no charge.
Oh no!
Imagine the Warsong Commander charge right now. How would it change the game, right?
It would probably change it to +1 attack to all your charged minions, right? That's how much it would change the game.
Right now? Yes.
Yeah, it would change the game.
I mean, the pre-nerf, of course. Well, basically you can execute Ghoul, go face.
Do you want to execute, or do you just pop the spider? With the ghoul and the cool task. Like, how do you play this? Whoa! What is Consecration? There's only one in that deck. There better be only one in that deck.
Owl works too.
Yeah, I mean, Owl is actually great.
It helps, but it doesn't solve the problem, because the fact is that Warrior is the beatdown right now. Has more power on board and more health. So, yeah.
Well, how long is it the beatdown for after you play Lotheb? Right, well, like, when I'm looking at this hand from Vanilla Titan, I feel like the Lotheb is going to put Leon in the position where he has to use his one card to remove board, which is the Execute. And then Vanilla Titan is a lot more likely to find great top decks than Leon is, just based on the fact that there is a Dr. Boom, two Challengers, one Tyrion left, possibly Shredders as well. So Vanilla Titan is happy to top deck, where Leon might be stuck with Whirlwinds and other gimmicky situational cards.
Yeah, that's true. You have to go for it, it's not a way, right?
Yeah, you have to just play the Armorsmith, attack that 5-5, execute, and then hope for the best.
Yes.
Maybe get a Millhouse Metastorm. Or another ghoul. Out of that Shredder.
Another ghoul would be pretty cool. But then...
Cool ghoul?
Yes, cool ghoul. But it's not an easy decision. What about if you just kill the 1-1s?
Sure. So you would go Armorsmith, kill the 1-1s, and let Lotheb damage itself, and then you execute it afterwards? I can get behind that. I think that's a great play. I love it. You're compensating with the damage that Lotheb would do by simply getting more armor on that turn.
I mean, the Lotheb will probably be used to kill the Armorsmith this turn.
Right. And then you're able to get the execute anyway, and you're also not going to pay 6 for it, which means you're going to be getting a cheaper deal. Instead of not being able to armor up, instead you can and simply play... Yeah, I think the turn you highlighted last turn was definitely the best one.
Oh. That's not bad. Actually, that's really not bad, because it doesn't die to Light's Justice, and that could have been possible. It could have been a 1-1 minion, whatever. And it's safe. It's just a save. We can assume that we'll trade to at least one minion. But what he needs desperately right now is a Whirlwind.
Well, that's a pretty good top deck. Oh my god. Leon, I mean, this is great for him just because he's able to reset the board to a position where he's got the advantage. He can lose the ghoul, he can lose the execute, and he'll wipe the entire board and be left with a 2-2. Alright, so it's all about who top decks whom at this point, right? We're kind of back to that exact position.
Well, if Tyrion will be drawn, then Leon is in big trouble.
Tyrion would be crazy.
Dr. Boom, of course, will be a problematic too. I mean, even Mr. Challenger with no secrets will be problematic.
Yeah, just give me, like, you could give me a Chillwind Yeti, and I'm in trouble, right?
Because no weapon kills that.
Hold on to the execute.
You would need Arcanite Reaper.
Do you ever hold on to this? There's no reason.
No. You have to use execute, because you're lacking any kind of activator.
Minibot. Okay. All right, Leon. Better find a Belcher. Better find a Shredder. Better find a Dr. Boom. Better find even a Grim Patron. It would be glorious here. He's got quite a few outs. I'll take that.
That's a good minion.
I'll take that.
Not being killed by the board. So you kill the 1-1 and armor up Volotip.
Yeah, because if you don't kill the 1-1, all you're doing is letting him use the mini boss shield very effectively. Whereas now you're forcing him to attack with a weapon, and that means he's taking the 2 damage that you would have dealt anyway. Ooh, looks like a Shredder from Vanilla Titan. It is. Both players getting good cards. It's about whoever whiffs the first, and I think Leon's got a lot more pressure put on him because he doesn't have a hero power that spawns pressure. Dread Corsair. Huh. Do you punch face? You can't really pop that Shredder, it's too risky.
No. I think you just punch face for 5. The aggressive play is the correct one. Play the Dread Corsair, because the Dread Corsair means that your opponent has to sacrifice the Divine Shield and the 1-1, and then he will get HP.
You will kill the weapon.
Mm-hmm. I mean, sorry, you will attack with the weapon to the Pyro Shredder, take 3. And then you trade with the 1-1 and the Pyro Shredder, so that's... He's not dead to a weapon, and that's huge. But slowly, Vanilla Titan is taking control of the board. And if that's not a... Okay, that's
That's 2 card draws right there.
Yep.
At this point, and it's also 1 damage, you have to deal with it, otherwise Death's Bite will kill you. I mean, at this point, I don't even think you can attack into it, though. But what about Cruel Task? Is that Tyrion? No!
Oh my god.
The draw to rule them all. We have seen patrons with Iron Beak Owls. Oh, that Death's Bite. You have a Grom Hellscream, right? Isn't there a Grom Hellscream somewhere in the... Ooh, the Boombots could do some work.
They can actually win the game single-handedly.
Yeah, I've seen it happen. So, is there a world in which you actually use Death's Bite first, attack the Tyrion, and then set up the Boombots so you wipe out all the 1 health minions to... No? Wouldn't you ever just set up the Whirlwind for the Boombots to kill the opponent? Is it really that bad? Thought it was actually the play, but... Maybe I'm looking too much into this.
I'm thinking about it, but I don't think that's the correct decision.
So taking an extra 6 is not worth it? Because you could use Inner Rage on the Secret Keeper, right? And then you Death Bite, you kill all the minions. The only one that lives is Tyrion.
But you know what I think? The Inner Rage should have been used on the mini bot right now. Reporting for duty. That's what I think.
I mean, the Boombots can still win the game.
My god, that's awful. 3 damage in the face.
We're getting close. That's cool, except it's not. But he's got the Death Bite. He can take a lot more damage in the process.
Oh my god.
That is clutch.
Now he can kill Tyrion.
He can not only kill Tyrion, but he can kill the Murloc and win next turn with a second Death Bite charge.
Yes, but you can't really show the Inner Rage right now. You just attack into the Tyrion and you play Whirlwind. Because your opponent then... Well, he might make a mistake. He will play only 1 card, so there's no difference what he will do. So you can save
what would hurt Noble Sacked up deck.
Yes, definitely.
I would cry. I would actually cry. This is such a close match. Now, what could Leon be waiting for? I mean, you could wait for Grom, right? Because Grom would actually be even better than anything else in your deck right now. Like, next turn, Grom would literally solve all your problems. It plays around Noble Sack, it plays around, you know, Challenger. All you need is the 4 damage from it. Oh, man. Vanilla Titan's down to 1 top deck, man. This is it. Belcher or Noble Sack? It's got to be either of those. I think this was an Avenge. That's it! Leon takes it!
Wow, that was a long game.
Longest game we've had today, for sure.
Yes, definitely the longest. Wow. And it was a really close one, too.
Down to the last card.
Okay. This is also the first time that we see Control Warrior winning against a Secret Paladin. Right?
That was Patron, but yes.
Oh, sorry, Patron Warrior against the Paladin.
Right, it should have the edge, technically, but we haven't seen it win today because every single time it happened, it seems like the Paladin just kept going on and on about how good their curve was, and their Patron was like, yeah, but I play gimmick cards, it's not fair that you can play your good stuff. And then Secret Paladin was like, it's not my problem, you play a scrub deck, so Patron started losing. it was a really sad day for Warriors.
Yeah. But Leon takes the first game, and now he will be sticking to the Patron Warrior. And what was the classes? Let me check.
Vanilla Paladin Warrior are the classes that the players have. So Patient Warrior is coming back. Secret Paladin's gone, so there's a Druid and a Warrior left from
So I guess the Druid will be picked up as a counter to the Warrior, right?
Yes, oh wait, no, it's because it's patron, which makes it difficult.
And nowadays players, nowadays players are not using Harrison Jones anymore, and that was one of the tech cards that was being used in Druid against Patron Warriors, and it actually made a huge difference in most of the games. So I guess
It's all about. Like, I feel like Druid is still better though, right? Unless you're playing control. I don't know. If you're playing Control Warrior is obviously the best.
Yes.
Which, in this case, we see Vanilla Titan with the Control Warrior. Prepare your drinks and food, because you're here for a while. This is basically... this can be a very long game.
It can be, or it doesn't have to be, because if the patron is not hitting his like super fast openings with patrons, and you know, it's quite surprising that Leon didn't keep his patron in opening hand, because I feel like that's the only win condition against Control Warrior. So if you hit it as early as possible, you go for it, because the only
I thought he would do. It's only bad if with brawl, and that's
exactly
it. And if you find it late, he just has more chances to find the brawl, and then you lose the game. So it's all about getting that patron early. But then again, maybe he's trying to play a very slow game. If he wants to here, he could definitely just go for a coin acolyte with inner rage to guarantee two card draws.
Yep.
Play it old patient style. You know, you just draw. Try to find the combos. And I mean, if a weapon comes out, then it's off curve for Vanilla Titan if it's the War Axe. But he wanted to armor up last turn, so he's probably pretty happy. If you're able to also deny some of the armor stacking from Vanilla Titan, that's worth a lot, right? So if you go for the Acolyte Inner Rage, you're able to deny more armor gain.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, the Bash, I love the card. Bash is just so neat, so powerful, so clean. But
yeah,
it's also...
I'm not sure why so few people like it. It's also like a bad slam in some cases, I guess.
Yeah, but I mean, the synergy with the class is so insane. Because you, when you think about slam, it's like, well, it's an okay card. It's basically add attack on your weapon and cycle. That's what it reads, right? But Bash is just basically the perfect synergy card for Warriors.
Well, it was probably my favorite card one of my favorite cards when it was announced. I think I agree with you. It's almost it's too clean, right, design-wise?
Yeah. I had the same impression. Like, I was saying that this is the new Shields Maiden. It should be played in every single Warrior.
Exactly.
No one was excited. I mean, I wasn't excited about Shields Maiden when it was announced, but I made I get my lesson from that. And when I saw Bash, I was like, okay, this is the new Shields Maiden, because it's so underrated. It's not flashy at all, but it's just so solid. It should be played in every single Control Warrior from now on.
Yeah, it's kind of okay. Think about Fiery War Axe, right? Like, if they ever release a Fiery War Axe, right? They ever release a weapon that's literally that. If it didn't exist in the core set for Warriors, you would look at Fiery War Axe and you would think to yourself, wow, this card is boring. You know, we already have, I don't know, like Ogre Warmall, we already have King's Defender, why would I want a 3-2 for 2 mana, right? It's just such a boring card. And then you actually play it, and you think to yourself, how did I not realize the amount of, like, the value this card held? Because it, like, the Bash acts both as removal and armor gain, which is exactly what Warrior is looking to do. Stack the armor and kill stuff. It's hard not to find value in it when you're playing that deck. Doomsayer! Alright, so you don't even have to try to kill whatever's out of it.
Yeah.
You're pretty happy here. You get a free removal piece, and you get to keep your armor for later. If you're Leon here, though, you have to remove some armor if you want to play Boom, because otherwise, Armor of Shield Slam takes care of it. Well, we got a Jesticar True Heart. If you go Bash Shield Slam, you can deal with Boom. Considering the few amount of threats you know exist in that warrior deck. I think Bash Shield Slime is definitely good.
Exactly what I wanted to say. The amount of pressure that can the Patron Warrior do to Control Warrior is just really low, especially if the Control Warrior runs double Brawls, because that's what you want to get for, the Patrons. I mean, Brawl and a weapon, and that's it. And in this situation, you can use the other means to just deal with the threats being played by Patrons. So Bash and Shield Slam, in my opinion, is a very convenient way of clearing a War Golem and leaving up the, you know, right. Fun ones.
Sure.
Otherwise,
you can play a Cruel Task if you want afterwards, but I think you might as well keep it for when you actually need to do it.
I don't know, maybe. Wait, what?
What was an error? Not playing the Cruel Task first?
What would be the reason?
I
mean, that
I
was no
exactly.
difference, right? That was no difference.
So wait, if you play Cruel Task first, I mean, it hits your face. Did you need more than... No, it could have hit you in the face for 3 and you would have been fine. So you could have maybe hoped to... It didn't matter anyway, though. Like, I don't know. Maybe saying that he didn't need to play the Cruel Task. Maybe he's trying to BM. Maybe he's trying to say that he doesn't have good
follow-ups.
I think
it was okay to play the Taskmaster because, or maybe he wasn't. He has a few War Axe.
I guess you can play Cruel Task. Yeah, I was gonna say like Cruel Task can be played with Execute, and in this case, you're also feeding it to the weapon. So maybe.
Mm-hmm.
So
okay.
Slam in a Rage. Or.
I feel like Slam in a Rage is the correct play here, because if you top deck a Whirlwind, you can always play that, and I think you should.
Yeah, and it's not as though you're ever going to get a board against against Control Warrior if
yes,
you wait.
Exactly.
There is no waiting ever. Like it's
you
just
have
never
to go
happening.
All-in. All-in SAP or bust.
Yeah. Now, Baron Geddon does deal with a portion of this board. Sylvanas could also be a consideration. If you want to. Oh, he's gonna go for Ysera.
That's interesting.
That's gonna backfire pretty hard if there's no Ysera Awakens, but
oh
there is!
Oh my god! He knew! He knew!
Oh,
he
that's
just
unfair.
He knew that he will get the Ysera Awakens to clear the Patrons. That's
that
easy, right?
Unfair. Feeling bad for Leon right now. You gotta feel bad for the underdog once in a while.
Hmm. Battle Rage for 2 cards, not bad. Basically.
So I would consider probably just attacking here and playing Execute with Lotheb. Force a Brawl that costs him 10 mana.
Yes.
Or would you
ace.
Use Patrons?
No, I think you should use Execute.
So what about the Axe and the Patron? Right? Because this one dies to your Whirlwind effect. Huh. Maximizing Patron value.
Okay, yeah, maybe that. Okay, I agree. That was a better play. My bad here.
Yeah, you're only getting tired because it's been quite a few hours you've been casting. It's only that, Lothar. Don't worry about it.
Of course.
Everybody loves you anyway.
We started 7 hours ago.
Yeah. And we're going to be running a bit late, I think.
Jessica running down, getting more armor than needed.
That's actually one of the most devastating things about Warrior nowadays. And I kind of want to touch upon that a bit, because I feel like Priests got really the worst end of the stick when it comes to Justicar, when you compare them with Warriors. What I find really disheartening is that Warrior is a very... Like, Armor is a very Warrior-centric mechanic. I mean, sure, Ice Barrier exists, Bite, mm-hmm. Claw, Hero Power for Druids, but it's effectively only synergizing with Warrior stuff. So it kind of feels bad that Warriors are getting so much of it, and Priests are getting a reactive hero power that almost never works nearly as well. So I feel like maybe one day armor is going to get out of hand and everybody's going to be really tired of it. And it might be sooner than we realize.
Yeah. I mean, that's a problem that we many times discussed about Priest. Priest hero power is the only hero power that doesn't do anything when the game is starting and you have a bad opening hand.
Yeah, it's really, it's reactive, right? That's pretty much it.
Exactly.
All right, well, Brawl with Sylvanas, I heard, is a pretty good play, Lothar. Can you confirm?
I confirm.
Okay, just want to make sure.
So,
I guess you can always wait. There's no hurry, right?
Well, you saw already. One patron wave. Okay.
Wait for the next one. Why not? If there is even a next one ever. Now, Leon could defuse the Sylvanas a bit. You know, he plays Cruel Task, let's say.
Hmm.
How do you play this, though?
I mean, the problem is... even if
how
you
do
clean
you kill
up the
him?
Board...
Yeah, exactly. That... how do you could... win? Like, your Death Bite does one turn of hero power as damage. It's irrelevant.
I guess you can execute face. Yeah. Only, you know what?
Battle cry, turn your enemy hero into a minion.
Oh my god, that would be powerful. I think the only thing, the only play you can do here to still maybe win this game is execute right now. And he gets the armor smith. And then you X a question to the armor smith.
Right, you're just like, how are you feeling today? With a big axe in the face, right?
Yes.
You ask him a really, really good question. Well, this brawl still a lifesaver if you want to pick it up. You could also just steal the Armorsmith if you're Vanilla Titan. You're like, I kind of want more armor. So you just go trade Sylvanas and Lotheb, get the Armorsmith, Cruel Task it, play the Acolyte of Pain. Why not? And then Belcher. And then get a massive AoE armor gain. Just to depress Leon out of the game. There's no way Leon sticks around, right? Unless he wants information, I guess.
Do you want information from Contra Warrior? I mean, he will not probably not show another, like, two bros till... I don't know, man. Oh, wow.
That's creative. Okay. It does put pressure on Leon to answer this, but he's got the answers. He's got no way to kill his opponent, but he's got answers.
I guess this is the turn when you say, I Battle Rage, if that's that card, that deck's card is not a patron, I concede. If it's a patron, I play it, and I kill my opponent minions and multiply my patrons. And then if my opponent plays Brawl and kills my patrons, then I concede.
Yeah, it's like, it's your last out. But you gotta go for it.
Whoops.
That looks like a double patron turn very soon, but I don't think it's sufficient. He's gonna have to go for the double execute play on this board and hope that he picks up a patron next turn.
Yes, exactly.
That's about all there is to it. He might let Lothar make the trade and then finish it off with the AoE later on.
Actually, that's good.
Yeah, that's all right. That's perfectly fine. Either he wastes his weapon and they die, like the Lothep dies to multiple AoEs over the course of your patron turn that you hope is coming up next turn. And then, if that's your last push and it gets defused, then you've got nothing else and you can just leave a happy warrior who did his best.
Happy warrior. Happy little warrior with an afro.
Yeah. Vanilla Ross. No, that's Leon Ross. Sorry. Oh. Garrosh? Oh no, Garrosh Hellscream! We have to make an actual emote of that. Garrosh! You're not fit to rule. The what? The afro? I'm not sure. It has to happen. Alright, so let's drag the game on! Alright, that is not what Leon wants to see.
Nope. And now he has to use one of the AoEs, right? Because he needs to clear the board. So this attack from the Taskmaster goes into the low tip. Then the weapon goes, I guess. Doesn't make any difference.
No, you can just use a whirlwind with your execute to kill the Dr. Boom. You don't have to waste your weapon, because your weapon could be worth quite a bit, right? It's a free whirlwind.
But you have a weapon in your hand.
Oh, you're right. Never mind. It's kind of unfortunate, but I guess it ends up adding up to something similar.
I don't know.
I feel like you're not getting the patron turn anyway, and if you are, it's probably not gonna be. It's not gonna be what you want from it.
It's not as impressive, right? But the game is over.
Game, right?
Yes, that's game.
At last. At last.
Vanilla Titan takes it. It's 1-1. The series is tied, and the next move would be. Would be of Lion to make, and I guess he
Paladin
can.
Paladin, I like, yeah.
Paladin? No, why not Druid? He has a Druid in his arsenal, right?
I think Druid's worse against Control Warrior than Patron. Worse against Control Warrior than it used to be. Maybe the Raptor changed that. Like, that's the one kind of wild card that we haven't seen enough to really make a guaranteed judgment on. But I feel like the Darnassus Aspirant version of Druid is a lot worse than the previous ones because it just doesn't play enough mid-game drops, and the 2-mana 2/3 just doesn't accomplish much. All you're ramping to is a Shredder at best, and the War Axe still deals with that.
Yeah.
But he does go for Druid, so I guess you're right. He does feel like that's the best option.
That would be my move. I like Druid still against Control Warrior. It just puts insane amount of pressure. You don't have to. I mean, it's cool to hit that Wild Growth, but at the same time, you have Shadow of Naxxramas. If you're not switching to Raptors, you have big minions that can deal a lot of the damage and are not vulnerable to weapons. So that's cool stuff.
Job's done.
And well, it doesn't look that great for Lion right now, because he did get two cards that are very retroactive, which is Swipe and Keeper of the Grove, and the first aggressive minion is Druid of the Claw. Oh wow, okay, that's a pretty bad draw. What he needs to pick up is a
Darnassus
Aspirant, Innervate, Wild Growth, or Shadow Naxxramas or Raptor. Depends on what he plays.
I was gonna say, I don't think he wants. At this point, I think the Aspirant is already too late to the party. Because you're either gonna run into a Coin, Deathblight, a Bash, a Fiery War Axe. There's a lot of things that could happen. And as a result of that, I think the Aspirant is mostly too late. So you're looking for Innervate and the Wild Growth or Shade or Raptor, as you said. And he's just not picking anything up. He's gonna be off curve. I mean, you're not going to want to play Keeper into a Coin Deathbite, I don't think.
Yep, definitely not. The problem is, like, if he gets Palter Shredder, it's super fine. Still, okay, maybe not super fine, but it's kind of okay-ish. Because you have a follow-up with Druid of the Claw in Taunt mode. Because it makes no sense to play Azure Drake when your opponent can just play Deathbite and kill it instantly. Even if it changed itself, you know?
Do you ever swipe the face?
No, I think you have to play the after... Keeper.
Okay. I was going to say, because what if you swipe face? I mean, Keeper is obviously doing something very similar to deny the armor gain. Keeper would be better. He's playing the slow game against the master of slow games. I'm not sure that's gonna work out very well for Leon. But we'll see what he picks up. If he gets himself an Innervate at any point. Things can get a little tricky because he can start making combination moves with two minions a turn and maybe turn the tide back in his favor.
Druid of the Claw makes
I was going to say, you know what's funny is I saw Vanilla Titan here coin out the Belcher, right? On this turn, Stan Sifka armors up and passes. And I feel like most of the time it still works to just armor up and pass and not even use your coin. Because you're just getting more armor for that Shield Slam. So it's kind of funny how many people play Warrior, Control Warrior in a very different way.
It would actually work right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it still works because you have Deathbite, so it's fine.
It's hard not to be fine when the first play the Druid makes is on turn 5.
Yep. Definitely.
I feel like at this point, you got all the time in the world. Wow, and I thought it couldn't get worse.
No, that's a good draw. Well, I mean, it's the best draw on turn 9.
Okay, now that you put it that way, it reassures me.
Well, this looks like a attack with the weapon and the bash.
See, I could see a bash. I was going to say, you just you don't even use the weapon. You just bash and trade with the Belcher. Keep your armor intact.
I think the Belcher is more valuable than the weapon, you know? Because
interesting.
The Belcher is something, it's that annoying for a druid. It's so annoying for the druid that he has to spare at least 2 cards to kill it, or maybe even 2 cards and a hero power. So using the weapon instead of the Belcher and bash makes it more awkward for the druid player.
Yeah, you're right. In this case, you know, he has to kind of swipe, which he doesn't want to do. He has to keep red down, which is good for you, because it's a very minor thing. You might keep the Acolyte for more draws. Right now, for Leon to win, I mean, look at the amount of armor that Vanilla has, right? It's very small. There are many games where, as the warrior, you're able to stack, you know, 8 armor by this point. Against Druid, it very rarely happens, and you're rarely getting a board against them. In this case, he's got the board, and he's got a bit of leftover armor, and on the back of the Justicar, he's going to be able to get even further.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's true.
Really, like, do you just Wrath the Belcher for 4 here? It's kind of the only play I see.
Then it gives your opponent another draw, which is annoying, of course. Huh.
So, Vanilla Titan could play Justicar and perhaps an Execute or Shield Slam. Pick your target. It's hard to say which one I'd prefer to play here, assuming I want to use my my Acolyte.
I think it's the turn for Justicar into Shield Slam. You just saw your opponent using Wrath, so there's a small possibility of him having a second one, and otherwise, if you're being, like, you know, you have a taunt already on board, so there's a little non-chance of your Justicar being killed this turn.
So at this point, what Leon's looking for is double combo. Leon's looking for, you know, an Emperor Thorsen with the other piece, the other Savage War, to get himself a crazy cheap double combo.
Or just and leave there, one Innervate. Because
sure,
that's also,
why not?
That also works.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Or wait, better yet, Force of Nature for 5, Force of Nature for 5, Innervate, double Savage War for 4. So that's like a 4-card Emperor.
Okay.
That would win pretty hard.
Yeah, but the warrior is in control right now, and he will deal with every single creature that we just smash on the board. Will be just smashed back by the warrior.
Whoa. Force of nature. I can't say I expected that. Of all the plays that were offered to Leon here,
I think it's...
Does he value his Keepers of the Grove that much? That's the assumption is yes, right?
Yes. I would say that he values...
I thought swipe.
Keeper and swipe looked like a valid option. I can understand his decision because he has another Force of Nature still in the deck, and it's only like you don't need the only one Force of Nature for the double combo.
That's a decent Dr. Boom Innervate Keeper if you want it. It's open to Brawl.
What about Ancient of Lore into Keeper?
Sure, that's definitely perfectly fine. You draw 2 cards and you cycle. You throw away the Innervate, but you've got another one in your deck still. And you're cycling with Wild Growth next turn anyway.
I don't think you can cycle next turn, because you probably will have to deal with some huge minions. So you need to play Big Game Hunter next turn. If you play Big Game Hunter, you'll like to develop Dr. Boom, because you're sure that your opponent will make a follow-up. And this is something that surprises me the most, because he has no follow-up.
Well, Vanilla Titan can opt to play Alexstrasza if he wants to, set up a Deathbite on the following turn, set up the Grom Lethal coming right up. Leon's going to be able to deal with the Alex very nicely by using BGH, could even heal himself with the Ancient of Lore if he wants to, which I think is going to be something he's going to consider. BGH, Dr. Boom perhaps, force a Brawl immediately so that there's no Deathbite set up.
Hmm.
Lotheb, Innervate Ancient of Lore, heal himself perhaps, or find card draw. There's a good chance that Leon can win next turn if there's no Brawl, right?
Yeah, but does execute, there's shield slam, there's become hunter, so...
Oh, never mind. I was thinking, like, from his perspective, he's going all in the hopes that there is no way for the warrior to deal with this.
Well, this turn looks easy, right? You go... You want to set up the two turns leaf, right? So you go for the death spite anyway, and you can just attack into Big Game Hunter. Then you play Big Game Hunter, and you can just armor up.
Yeah, I was gonna say you could even That's 9 mana, right? So you could even add the Shield Slam on top to kill the BGH and keep your armor intact.
Oh yeah, right. That's even better. Any attack phase with the weapon. Okay, yeah, that's way better.
Yeah, it barely saturates the mana, like, you know, more, but it's just enough that...
You just use Bash on the Big Game Hunter.
Okay, that's depressing.
Why would you do that?
To use Bash? At the very end of the sequence? That's gotta be the play, right? Whoa! Alright,
okay, I didn't understand. Doesn't want to use Bash.
Well, it's kind of the same end result, but I'm not
Boombot
so much.
It's not, because the potential of Shield Slam is way higher than Bash. And with your hero power gaining 4 armor per turn, but with 6 mana combo, you deal 3 damage to one target and 7 damage to the other one.
So what I see here is that Venal Titan was probably playing around a double combo from Leon with the Boombots. If the two Boombots were left to live, he was going to die to double combo, assuming it came up. And now he's also still got the next turn lethal, right? If the BGH lives.
Okay.
But I still think the play was unexpected, at the very least. Like, I thought it was going to be a bit more straightforward than this, and the Bash looked more valuable, but... Uh-oh.
Those are some
gonna
good
have to
bombs.
Deal with these. Gonna have to deal with these.
Well, that looks like a card draw for me, because he needs to get that combo, right? Oh, he heals!
Alright, so he's afraid of Cruel Taskmaster lethal, probably.
But he has,
and he's still setting up for a combo lethal, sort of.
Well, he'll draw one card, so he'll not have mana for next turn unless he top decks the Force of Nature. And he knows that the Angel of Law will get killed. Okay.
Alright, so Lothab Shade doesn't really deny much. The Brawl is still on 10 mana if ever that's needed. And the more you put on this board, the Belcher, as long as it's there, doesn't really care one bit. So your best way to win here is to make that Shade grow and dodge the Brawls.
Does he even play Shades? Because we didn't see one, right?
Well, he does have Shades right now. Like, they're on the board.
Jesus. Play. Really, I'm getting tired.
yeah, we're a bit late in the tournament. It's running, it's gonna run a few more matches, as you might imagine. So Keeper of the Grove here can deny the Belcher, and you've got double roar, right? So technically, if this Shade lives, it might do a bit of work. And you do have to address this Lothab if you're Vanilla Titan. His plays were consistent with playing around double combo. Does he still think that's what Leon's holding after all that's been played?
Well, if that's the case, he should play around it again, right? I mean, he was setting up for a two turns lethal, and that's not the case anymore. So if he goes for Isera, then he can't armor up. He can go for
Isera. He's got a Nightmare and an Isera Awakens for lethal, right? Because you punch face for 3 with the Belcher, and then he's on 17, and you're able to get Grom with Fiery War Axe for lethal with your current board. So there's a 40% chance that he gets lethal right away, just based on the top deck.
That's true. Wrath. Well, he will use the Wrath to
sight. So Keeper of the Grove, double roar is unfortunately not remotely enough. He's gonna have to play it a bit slower than this. He's cycling, right?
Yes, he's cycling, but I'm surprised that he didn't use the Keeper.
He might want to keep her Isera. Just stop it from spawning more nightmare type cards.
Okay, that's viable.
And now you're spawning enough minions on the board that, I mean, Brawl will always push you off the game. But you're not even playing for Brawl at this point. You're playing for literally just the combo play.
I think you have to play Darnassus Aspirant right now. You have to get more minions on board. You have double Savage Roar. You need the damage. If you top deck Druid with the Claw and charge, and your opponent kills one of the creatures, just one, then you have three left. That's four minions with Druid with the Claw, so that's 16 damage from double Savage Roar.
You can only play one Roar with Druid, though.
Oh yeah, what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Yeah, okay, never mind. I mean, he still has to go for that play, no matter what happens. He has to hope that everything works out. We know for a fact that Vanilla Titan with the Execute is, and the War Axe and the Dream is able to deny this board very nicely. So wait, if you go face... Yeah, the extra armor from the Armorsmith will also put Leon even further away from the win.
In this situation, Armorsmith weapon, you can dream... You can dream Darnassus, basically.
Yeah, why not? It doesn't really matter to you. As long as everything you have on the board is dead, you can dream Keeper. You can dream
so
nothing.
He doesn't dream anything.
Like, it doesn't even matter.
Okay.
Like, you're looking at 29 health. How do you push? Like, you need double combo.
Okay, that's the first step. First step is quite nice.
Four, five, and eight.
Actually, damage.
Yeah. But
well, you need to play
that. Need something to survive.
4, 5, 8, 12. Well, there's no lethal from Vanilla Titan yet. Good placement for the Shredder. Kudos.
So now, with the Dream, Vanilla Titan can deny the value. Oof.
Do you agree with that trade? I was thinking about
it. I'm not
sure,
man.
Oh, too much armor to kill your opponent!
Because what I'm thinking about is, do you need that Shade to live? If so, like, you know, with the double combo, right? Because it represents nine damage and possibly more if the game goes on even a bit longer.
Mm-hmm.
So is that worth, like, do you think the Armorsmith is going to deal nine or more? Or give nine or more armor to your opponent? If you think so, then that's definitely a good trade. So Shield Slam with Dream and Grom basically cleans the board up. There's no two ways about it.
And
for Vanilla Titan to lose this, I mean, you know what? He could even enable his Grom, right? If he wants to, you just like attack into the minion, play Grom, Shield Slam it, and then that's giving you a lot of damage. Hell, he's got every option in the world. Now Leon, what's he got? Still has to go through 30 health. Back to turn one.
But it's still not lethal for next turn. Okay. That actually makes a difference because it's not cleared by Isera.
Another Shade would do a lot of work, right?
Innervate. That has to be piled to Shredder.
You have to play it right now, because you can still play your Force of Nature Double Roar. There is no way you can afford playing a 2-3 into a War Axe. This is the only chance he's got. There's 11 on board right now for Vanilla Titan, so if he finds anything that deals damage, I mean, with the Grom Hellscream, he's close enough to getting it done.
Okay, this is also cool, because now we can push Isera into Ancient of Law, push his weapon into Palter Shredder in that order, just to avoid taunts from the Palter Shredders. And Baron Geddon to armor up. Okay, that unfortunately doesn't clear the drop from the Shredder. But I think
Baron
Geddon
being played. Yeah, I think to be consistent with the game plan, you still have to go for that line of play. Because if you leave the 5-5 up, that's the only time where the double combo will really punish you. I mean, there's still 26 health you're sitting on.
You will be at 28 after Baron Geddon armor up, so
right.
28.
You're dead. The double combo. You're exactly dead.
That's exactly dead. The double combo.
Yeah,
that's
exactly dead.
And
pick it up.
Swipe. Nope.
Does that help him? So if you swipe Geddon, You can't clear it up, so you'd have to trade your aspirant into it. I still think you have to swipe Geddon and trade away the aspirant into Geddon, then play your other aspirant and go face by armoring up. But then the lethal you were looking for is gone. There's no more lethal, even with Force of Nature top deck.
Yeah.
That's it. Mm-hmm. All right, I can't see Leon win this. Is there even a card that could save him? Tree of Life. even that's not good.
Yeah, that's not good enough. Basically, that prolongs the agony.
Yeah. He's gotta know. Is he gonna try to full clear? Yeah, he's gonna try to full clear. That's gonna feel pretty bad when Ground Hellscream falls down. I mean, you saw the Alex early. You have to assume that the opponent's holding Ground. This is probably still the correct play, though. All things considered, this is the way you have to play the turn. Hope that your little aspirant can be the extra damage you need with the Force of Nature top deck, assuming Ground doesn't show up. But it's not gonna be the case, and Vanilla Titan is gonna take it again to the one with Control Warrior, which we're gonna see again. And Leon's down to one deck, his Paladin.
His Paladin, and if it's, I guess it's Secret Paladin, because if it would be a midrange Paladin that is heavily favored against Control Warrior, I could even say that, safely say, it's almost certain that he will take it to the fifth game, but right now, unless the Paladin will curve out with really good mini bots in the beginning, and turn 6 Mysterious Challenger, it might look rough for him.
I mean, the thing is, Secret Paladin's also considered favored against Control Warrior. The double bash helps a lot if you're Control Warrior, the double brawl variants as well. But usually Secret Pally, if it's able to get stuff like Minibot on the board early and start snowballing and playing on curve, the Warrior is just running out of options. The Zombie Chow variants are worse because they give him health at some point and your top decks become worse. But if you're playing just a standard list, then you're still favored. So I'm surprised we didn't see the Paladin from the last game.
Well, in my eyes, the Druid was still favored, so I can see that decision being made. But now he will have another chance to redeem himself, and well, that doesn't look bad. Control Warriors usually run only one Whirlwind, so the Masterful Battle turn 3 is a good play.
Yeah, it's hard to get pushed off of it. It all depends on what he plays on 2. That gives you a lot of information about what he's got. If he's playing the Axe, then that means he doesn't necessarily have minions, like, because when you've got something like a Creeper on the board, the Armorsmith is a lot more tempting, right? So if you see the Axe, you know that there's possibly no Acolyte, because he might have coined that out, or if he's got the Armorsmith. But in this case, anything goes. You see the Armorsmith, he might have the Axe, he might have the Acolyte, he might have coined Deathbite, he might have anything. So that's the scariest opener from a Warrior, if you're the Paladin.
But you have to go for it, otherwise you're stopped in the tracks, because your hand is pretty much dry, and you have to get targets for that Blessing of Kings.
Yeah, you absolutely have to get something down on the board, and the way Leon's playing this, he's guaranteed to get a Kings on 4, and probably another one on 5 with one of the secrets that he's got. I'd like to see Repentance come out early, that way he can deal with Belchers, but we'll see how he ends up handling this. Ah, now that's... You see, I'd probably play this right now.
Yes, because usually consecrations have no value at all in this matchup.
I'm surprised he's even getting a little bit of value out of it, so... it's really rare. Usually you're like, yeah, I can kill a slime with this, I guess.
Or finish off the Belcher after attacking with the Knife Juggler.
Exactly, there's almost no way to use it. So this is good for him that he found a way to use a consecration earlier and do something. Now, Vanilla Titan is still looking very strong here. He's got the armor that he can, you know, just stack with the bash, with the single hero power, the shield block. So there's not going to be enough damage coming in to really threaten him. Not for now, at least.
Mm-hmm. So, this turn looks like a secret turn with Mini, but the only problem if you do that is that you'd say to your opponent, I don't have a Mysterious Challenger for next turn.
Unless you expect him to trigger stuff, but yeah, you're right. You're selling him a big telegraph with your address on it and exactly what you're going to play next.
Mm-hmm. So I don't blame him for playing the Blessing of Kings here. It's basically like a charge minion that has to be played on a mount. It's basically the spider rider.
It's all right, yeah. Oh no. But I kind of like the fact that he played Avenge afterwards, because that means whatever comes out of it is going to get buffed immediately. Which is definitely a good way to get some extra damage in that you otherwise might not be able to.
Will get attacked by the weapon, right?
Sure, but then you can Kings whatever other minions on and play Mini Bar on too. Oh, the Avenge doesn't trigger. Turns out we're wrong.
I think this was
a player priority issue, because they've got the mechanic in the game where one of the players is given priority when it comes to triggers. So I'm actually a bit surprised by this.
I was going with the flow, what you're saying, but it turns out something is, wait, what?
Yeah, I got really surprised here, because I have the secrets ordering down, like when it comes to Avenge triggering on dead minions and everything. I thought this was one of those cases.
But I was surprised there's no Dr. Six, even though we have one secret up.
Get the Avenge out, I guess. If this Avenge goes on the 5-5, that BGH is going to be so strong. Oh my god. But Challenger can still stay alive now. Because you've seen the BGH used up on a small minion, you know the Challenger, even if it eats up the Avenge, you're going to be cool with this. Ooh. And this is a perfect way to replenish your hand.
It is. And you know what's even more crazy? That you still have one Light's Justice here. Wow, he has a full tree. What? What is this?
Yeah, he's going to be able to play his Repentance.
Sacred Trial?
No, just Competitive Spirit, Avenge.
Oh, yeah, right. He used one Avenge. Okay, never mind.
Yeah.
He used only one Avenge, yes.
It just triggers. So there's one more left. I think the Divine Favor being top deck here is a really big deal for Leon. It's going to be a priority to play, but now Vanilla Titan has the option to kill it. If he wants to kill some of the stuff on the board, he has the opportunity to, but it's just going to feel absolutely terrible. You don't want to play Minion, because you know there's Repentance. You don't want to play Removal, because you know there's Avenge and Redemption, so no matter what you do, you don't like it. Maybe Bash, Execute, Shield Slam is the way to go.
Mm-hmm. That looks harsh. Huh. I feel that like the only play here is Shields Maiden and Shield Slam to kill.
What about Belcher Pass?
And then execute. Okay, Belcher Pass. Your Belcher gets Repentanced, and then you get 7 damage to the face from the Mysterious Challenger. That's not appealing, I would say. So even though Shields Maiden, Shield Slam, execute. Oh wait, that's 7 mana.
What about a Shield Slam execute? Belcher, Shield Slam, the 6-6, execute it. Comes back.
Redemption, 6-1. Right? I was just thinking about Shield Slamming it to kill it and then to finishing up with the execute, but that's of course not the case. So no, it feels like the Belcher is the only possible play.
Yeah, let the secrets sit there for a little while, let Leon do what he wants with them. Noble Sack is going to sit dead, but it's going to give him the ability to draw 4 cards off of this Divine Favor, which is very powerful. If he finds pretty much anything at this... Oh god, that is crazy good.
Yeah, even my cat said something about that.
He's like, oh, that's nasty, Lothar. Make them stop.
Exactly.
Reminds me of that post I saw on the general forums for Hearthstone. It's a guy who said, I just started playing this game, and I don't understand how you're supposed to beat this deck that puts a lot of question marks on the board. Is there a way, like, it was funny, he's like, he plays one card, and then there's 5 question marks, and they do stuff, and I don't know what happens, and then I'm like, he has a massive board. I'm like, oh my god. And the worst part is, you know it's true, because new players have no understanding of what's happening when those cards fall. Things just pop on their screen. Like animation after animation after animation, and they've got no idea what's going on.
Actually, it sounds hilarious when I think about it.
So he's got lethal here. You just push phase, then you play Juggler, Dr. Boom, Kidla Boom Boss that kill your Boom Boss that kill him.
Mm-hmm. Sounds about right.
It's hard not to find lethal here.
Easy lethal.
Yeah. I think he sees it. Yeah, he sees the lethal. He's pretty good at this game.
Okay, first turtle to the... Oh. And... Bomb Ghost. It's Mr. Chandra. Never mind. He is at 4 HP.
All right, so we have Bash, Shield Slam. We have Shield Maiden, Shield Slam, but it doesn't help. We had an Execute, but it doesn't help. You have to attack with the Boombot first. That's your first step, right?
Yes.
That's got to be your first step.
Wait, why into the Nav Jogger? Oh, no, he's not doing that.
I mean, Noble Sack doesn't trigger on a full board, does it? Not anymore. I think they fixed it.
No, it doesn't trigger for a long time.
So he knows for a fact that he's dead if he attacks his Boombot.
Yep.
Well, I haven't seen where the Boombot went, but I'm pretty sure it's phased for 4.
Oh my god, it's 2.
There was 2.
Redemption on the bomb. Oh no.
That can't be good.
What do you do now?
Dr. Balanced. You bash execute, man. You got no choice. Bash, execute, armor up, shield slam, kill that 7-4 over there.
And he's
still dead. Hey, it was a valiant attempt. Don't mock him. He did what he could, but it's Secret Valley. And they do what they want. Click to continue. Player 2, press start to enter game.
And you have to, you know, just push some credits into the arcade machine.
Yeah, put another dollar here, maybe you become Control Warrior. And then, he put in a lot of credits in that machine.
Oh, God. Okay, so it's 2-2, basically. And Leon has his last chance, and it will be against Druid, if I'm not mistaken, right?
It's going to be it's gonna be Secret Valley from Leon versus Druid from Vanilla Titan, yes.
Mm-hmm. So Druid versus Paladin versus Secret Paladin. Did we see that already?
We saw it once, and I think the Secret Pally ran over the Druid, even though we figured it might have a good chance. Technically, Druid should be able to wipe the board if it gets, you know, the swipes on time. But the thing is, because of the way Pally works, if you don't get, you know, Aspirant, and this is a funny thing because the Paladins just have no good way of dealing with the Aspirant, right, when it comes out on curve.
Yes.
If you don't get Aspirant, there is no way you can beat their board. Almost. It's just remotely... it's not remotely possible unless you get some crazy innervates.
Mm-hmm, that's true, but he has Darnassus Aspirant and he has Wild Growth. At some point of the Fury crafting and Fury matching, I would say, I was thinking about not keeping Wild Growth in this matchup. Because it's so important to get that early game. That you have to fish for the Darnassus Aspirant, basically. But I might be wrong.
Yeah, that's right.
But it definitely applies.
I think you have a good point, though. You have a good point. So, here. You play Keeper for the board. And you just kill that 2-2. Because I feel like you want to play stuff. You can get the 6 mana. Make sure that you can get yourself that, Shredder plus Hero Power or Keeper Hero Power. The problem you're running into is that if there's a coin True Silver, whatever you play next is going to feel a bit awful. It's going to have to be the Druid Claw.
But it played directly into Massive Battle.
Yeah.
I don't like that. I mean, you still have a Pile Shredder next turn, but it dies to the board.
Well, what's the alternative, right? Match. You can't really kill the 2-2 without trading away the Aspirant.
Oh yeah, that's for sure. But if you play Keeper and help him with that, then you have a board. And even if your opponent plays True Silver Champion, you still have a board with Darnassus Aspirant, right?
Right, that's what I thought he would do. Play the Keeper just to get a 2-4, not for, you know, it's a big threat, just because it's a 2-4 body.
I just
got the coin Challenger into Challenger into Dr. Boom. Like, if things go really, really badly with the first Challenger, the second one's gonna carry. There's a chance, though, that Vanilla Titan is able to get a Force of Nature combo earlier than later, because now he's got the Keeper of the Grove, he's got the Shade, and if those stick, that can change a lot of things.
Yep. So,
full Christmas tree.
Full Christmas tree, and it's almost December, so it actually fits. nowadays.
Is he calling the Jingle Hell?
Well, he should have a Coca-Cola can in his hand.
Oh God.
It's basically, you know, a truck, a Coca-Cola truck.
I can imagine Uther with a Santa Claus suit just coming up to you, right? He's like,
and bringing all
ruining
those,
your Christmas.
I'm bringing all those bottles with the, instead of the Coca-Cola logo, there's, you know, just a question mark on all of those bottles.
That sounds terrifying. So here, Final Titan is going to opt for the Force of Nature that you've just picked up to trigger all the secrets. It's going to give him the ability to get rid of normal stack, maybe clean up some of the leftovers. He can also, if the Avenge doesn't hit too poorly, deal with a 4-3. Ugh, he's going to have to... Okay, so my question to you is, at this point, if you're Vanilla Titan, do you ignore the board and try to push for a combo soon? Like, do you just ignore everything?
That's a very hard decision. Because your opponent now deals so much damage, I don't think you can actually... you can actually...
Win the race?
Win the race. And I think trading... That was actually the turn when you had to trade for the 6-8 with the remainings of the remains from the Force of Nature and the Pilot Shredder. Because now, that's how much damage?
There was a total of about 19, I think. 18 or 19 on the board.
So, that's a lot.
And Leon is like, that is really weird. Why is he attacking my face? Does he have combo number 2 with an Innervate?
Yeah, that's
he's pretty close to it, right? Yeah.
This is why he, Leon just did trade with the small minions just to prevent a weird form of Innervate turn 8 combo. Because that would allow Vanilla Titan to still do win. But otherwise...
But right now there's no way for Vanilla Titan to win. That's it. It's gone. Yeah. Nothing will save him. Silencing these guys won't do anything. And attacking into them will just kill him faster. So Vanilla Titan's pretty much out of it. Unless Leon disconnects, but no, Vanilla Titan won't even let him misclick the Alt F4. And Leon's gonna take the 3-2 in this quarterfinal. We're gonna have a semifinals and finals match afterwards. That was a very long series, Lothar.
Yeah, it was. And the reason is that there were 2 warriors, 2 druids, and 2 paladins. So there was a lot of like counterplay, right? And even with counterplay, the games were pretty dragged out. So, well, you know, congrats to Leon. He gets to the semifinals, so he's 2 steps away from sealing his trip to Birmingham for the Insomnia Land to participate in the 30k tournament. But for now, we'll have a break, and then we go for the semifinal, Noctis versus Curse.